Once we returned from the school, the children's disrespect continued.
You're not eating candy now.
Why? I got a first swap.
That's nice, but you're still not eating candy.
It's my swap.
It's irrelevant, Kayla. You're not eating
swap.
Kayla, listen to me. You're not eating sugar now, and that's that.
I'm just trying to take a present off. My God, will you just leave me alone?
Not right now.
That's quite typical, is it? To get the sassy mouth,
all
Kayla.
All the time.
The way Kayla disrespects her mum is troubling enough, but then both kids decided to ignore mum when she wanted them to do their homework.
Hello. You do a little homework? Just maybe a little bit?
At 9 o'clock.
At 9 o'clock, why? What? It's 8:40. What is happening between now and 9 o'clock? You can't do homework.
Too rest.
You always want rest. You're finding an excuse.
After watching these kids treat their mum like a doormat and negotiate at what time they were going to do their homework, I thought to myself, at what point is dad going to step in? But he didn't.
If you only have 5 problems, we can just pound those out fast and you'll be off the hook.
Brandon's in 5th grade and Kayla's in 3rd grade. And at 9 o'clock, these kids should be getting ready for bed, not doing their homework.
We're having a test tomorrow. What is it that we're having a test on?
So hold on a minute. There's a test going on tomorrow. This is the first time that you've seen any of the work, any of the...
Yes.
And it's...
9:30
at night.
Yes.
I don't know how these kids get enough sleep because they're doing their homework far too late. And how can homework be a priority for these children when the parents don't make it a priority themselves?
She wants you to read 30 pages of science?
So wait a minute, she's expected to read...
Page 58 through 83, that was tonight.
25 pages?
Yeah, in addition to that, in addition to a big project due on Friday.
So she's behind in her homework anyway? No, not?
There should be more progress during this week towards getting it done, so it's not going to be...
So the teacher's not actually being unreasonable?
No, assuming that the child follows directions. The problem is...
Why wouldn't a teacher assume that a child would take direction?
Oh, well, our children don't follow directions. That's the problem.
Right, so who allowed it to happen?
I guess it's our fault again.
I think it's mad that these parents don't even know what assignments their kids are doing or what time it's due in, considering homework is where they have problems.
So what time exactly will... everybody go to bed tonight?
We'll let you know tomorrow.
I mean, basically now it's stuff back in backpack. Put our nightie on, brush teeth, bed. So that's what, 11 o'clock?
11 o'clock. Are you kidding me? I made my way home. I told Mum and Dad, get a good night's sleep because tomorrow morning we're going to have a family meeting and it's going to be some straight talking going on here.
What can we do to help you, Kayla, so we can get it done?
Well, for now, let's just...
Okay, let's just go. I think everybody wants to
go to bed.